हेलो स्टूडेंट्स, आई एम नरसिम लू, कॉमर्स टीचर। टुडे आई एम गोइंग टू टीच यू सीईसी सेकंड ईयर अकाउंटेंसी यूनिट टू कॉम कंसाइनमेंट अकाउंट्स पार्ट 7 सिंपल प्रॉब्लम्स प्रिपरेशन ऑफ लेडजर अकाउंट्स इन द बुक्स ऑफ बोथ द पार्टीज। Dear students, in this video, I will explain the procedure to prepare ledger accounts in the books of consignor and in the books of consignee. Okay, students, in the last video, I have explained how to write the journal entries in the books of consignor as well as in the books of consignee. In this video, I will explain the procedure, the way, how to prepare ledger accounts in the books of consignor as well as in the books of consignee. Students, in this video, for the given problem, we are going to make working notes and preparation of ledger accounts in the books of consignor, preparation of ledger accounts in the books of consignee. So these three things you will learn in this video. Now see the problem. Dear students, take a pen and notebook. Take down this problem in your notebook and pause the video. Take down the problem clearly. All the points you can go to take down in your notebook. Then listen the problem. I will read it out. Consignment problem. Subhash of Siripur consigned to Hari of Hyderabad 60 boxes of medicines at rupees 400 each. Subhash paid freight and insurance amounting to rupees 2000. Hari sent rupees 10,000 as advance payment against consignment. Subhash received an account sales from Hari containing the following particulars: gross sale proceeds or rupees 34,000, transportation and warehousing charges rupees 1500, commission charged at 15% on gross proceeds. Subhash received bank draft for the balance due from Hari. Prepare necessary ledger accounts in the books of consignor and consignee. Dear student, this is the problem. Let me explain you each and every point that is in the problem. See, in the first sentence, there are two parties. One is Subhash of Siripur, another party Hari of Hyderabad. So here Subhash of Siripur is the consignor and Hari of Hyderabad is the consignee. And the goods sent on consignment, 60 boxes of medicines of rupees 400 each. If we multiply 400 rupees with the number of boxes, then we will get the value of goods sent on consignment. So that is rupees 24,000. Subhash paid freight and insurance amounting to rupees 2000. So here Subhash means consignor. Consignor expenses on consignment rupees 2000. And see, Hari sent rupees 10,000 as advance payment against consignment. So here consignee given 10,000 rupees to the consignor as advance. Subhash received an account sales from Hari. So here Hari prepared an account sales and sent it to the consignor, means here Subhash. Subhash received that account sales from consignee. And this account sales containing some particulars. Go to see what are there. Gross sale proceeds are rupees 34,000. Here the entire stock was sold by the consignee for rupees 34,000. Transportation and warehousing charges rupees 1500. Here consignee met 1500 rupees expenses on consignment. Okay. Commission charged at 15% on gross proceeds. So on 34,000, if we calculate at the rate of 15%, we will get 5,100 rupees. So here that is the commission. And come to next one. Subhash received bank draft for the balance due from Hari. For the settlement of the consignment account, Hari sent a bank draft to consignor. And here last point is that prepare necessary ledger accounts in the books of consignor and consignee. So here we are asked to prepare only ledger account, preparation of ledger accounts in the books of consignee and consignor. Okay students, so what are the necessary accounts? I will tell you. Here in the books of consignor, the necessary accounts are three. One is consignment account, and second one consignee account, third one goods sent on consignment account. These three are the important accounts that we have to prepare in the books of consignor. And second, when we talk about consignee, we have to prepare only one book, that is only one account, that is consignor account. Now we have to make working notes from the problem. See here, working note points. I already explained each and everyone. Just you observe here. Consignor. Who is the consignor in this problem? Subhash of Siripur. Consignee. Who is the consignee in this problem? Ari of Hyderabad. Goods sent on consignment. So the value of goods sent on consignment is rupees 24,000. And how we got that 24,000 rupees? 60 boxes into 400 rupees. So if you calculate 60 boxes multiplied by 400 rupees, you will get 24,000. Okay students, that is the goods sent on consignment value. Consignor expenses. Here consignor spent rupees 2000. Consignor spent rupees 2000 on consignment goods. Freight and insurance amount, that is. Advance received from consignee rupees 10,000. Okay, cash in the form of cash we received amount in advance from the consignee. And goods sold by the consignee. So the entire stock was sold for rupees 34,000. Consignee expenses. In this problem, consignee expenses rupees 1500. That is transport expenses. Commission on sales. In the problem, it is clearly given at the rate of 15%. We need to calculate on sales of the consignee. So total sales made by the consignee is rupees 34,000. On that, if we calculate at the rate of 15%, we will get 5,100. That is the commission. And next point, profit or loss that made should be transferred to profit and loss account. So after preparation of consignment, we will know how much profit we will make on consignment account. And due amount paid by the consignee. So after preparation of consignee account, we come to know what is the due amount will be there for settlement of consignment account. Okay. Right. Now go for the next slide. Here we can go to prepare the ledger accounts in the books of consignor. In the books of consignor, first account, consignment account. See here, first account we prepared, consignment account. So only one item that comes on the credit side of consignment account, that is sales, consignee sales. How much amount is spent on consignment? The entire stock was sold by the consignee for rupees 34,000. That can be taken in the credit side of consignment account. Come to debit side. Here consignor expenses, first we can go to goods sent on consignment amount. First we have to write, that is as a point one. 24,000. Goods sent on consignment. To goods sent on consignment account 24,000. And consignor expenses to cashier bank account. B point. Cashier bank account to cashier bank account 2,000. Okay, students. Next, D point. Here, to consignee account. Consignee expenses. Here, consignee met on some expenses on consignment is rupees 1500. So that should be taken as a D point. And E point. Sorry, F point. Consignee account means here hurry to consignee account amount 5100 in the brackets. If you want, you can go to write commission on sales for understanding point of view. So how many points we have written on the debit side of the account? First one, goods sent on consignment, that is rupees 24,000, and B point, expenses met on consignment, that is 2,000, and C point, that is consignee account 1500. D point, sorry, next two point, that is expenses after writing that expenses on the debit side. Next we can go to take commission 5100. If you go to deduct total debit amount from the total credit, we will get the difference, that is 1400. That is the profit. That is the profit that we made on consignment stock. So in this way, we have to prepare consignment account. The entire process posting of the journal information in the ledger account should be think in our mind. But the blind, if you want to also follow a trick or a method, a technique, that is credit side, you can go to write sales, and debit side, consignor, goods sent on consignment amount and consignor expenses. After that, consignee expenses, consignee commission, 4 points. If you deduct the debit amount from the credit amount, you will get the difference amount, that is the profit. Okay, that is the profit, and you can go to write here to profit on loss account rupees 1400. Okay, students, in this way we can go to prepare consignment account in the books of consignor, first account, and second account, consignee account. Second one, consignee account. First one, consignment account. Second one, consignee account. Okay, consignee account. See here, students. Consignee means here, Hurry of Hyderabad. So debit in this account, debit side, we can go to take total sales that he made. That is 34,000. Consignee sales rupees 34,000 debit side. And credit side, come to credit side, advance payment. C point, as advance payment by cash or bank account 10,000. D point, by consignee expenses 1500, means here by consignment account in bracket consignee's expenses, okay, rupees 1500. And F point, so commission on sales, by consignment account in bracket commission 5100. So the difference, that is the due amount 17,400. Okay, the difference we will get after deducting the total credit amount from the total debit amount, we will get the difference figure. So here, that is 17,400. Okay, students, all the process, all the ledger posting means journal entries can be posted in the ledger accounts, and that process should be happen in our mind, or we can go to apply, or you can go to use a technique, that is credit side, debit side of the consignee account, you can go to write sales, and credit side, advance and his expenses and commission should be taken credit side, and from the total debit you can go to deduct these three items, then we will get the total of these three items, then we will get the difference amount, that is a bank amount 17,400 due amount, that is given as a draft to consignor for the settlement of consignment account. Okay, students, so total amount 34,000. Next, we have to prepare goods sent on consignment account. Here only two transactions we can go to record in this ledger account. So one is goods sent on consignment account credit side. First you can go to write consignment account 24,000. Here wrongly printed, it is 24,000. And debit side, you can go to write goods and turn, trade to trading account 20,000, to trading account 24,000. Here wrongly printed, I said just before, consignment account 24,000, trading account transferring, we are transferring that amount to trading account 24,000. Like this, we have to prepare three ledger accounts. One is consignment account, and by preparing the consignment account, we can go to find the profit or loss that we made on consignment. In this problem, we made profit, that is 1400, and we need to prepare consignee account as a second account. Okay, students, by preparing this account, we come to know the due or balance amount in the consignee account that we have to collect from him. And in this problem, that is amount 17,400, and that is sent as a draft by the consignee to us. And last one, goods sent on consignment account. Here credit side, first we have to write consignment account rupees 24,000. That same amount you can go to transfer to trading account 24,000. Okay, students. Next come to in the books of consignee, and we need to prepare consignor account. Okay, it is the book. It is the book of consignee. In the consignee book, we need to prepare one account, that is consignor account. It is the mirror reflection of consignee account in the books of consignor. Same points here will be shown, but opposite side. See, it is the consignor account. In the credit side, we have to take sales. Credit side, we have to take sales rupees 34,000. Okay, and debit side, advance payment, that is rupees 10,000. Whose advance here? Consignee is advance. Debit side, we have to write. And consignee's expenses 1500. Consignee's commission 5100. And if you deduct the total debit amount from the credit amount, we will get the difference amount. For that, we have drawn a draft and sent it to consignor, that is bank account 17,400. See, all this process, all the posting process should be happen in our mind, and directly we can go to write the entries in the account, because we are not preparing all the ledger accounts, only necessary ledger accounts we are preparing. So here in the books of consignee, we can go to prepare only consignor account when we are not preparing other ledger account. So it's the process should be happen in our mind, and otherwise we can go to use a technique that credit side we can go to take sales, and debit side advance payment, expenses and commission. These three items should be deducted from total sales, and the difference that we'll get, and that amount should be payable to consignor. So in this problem, consignee paid the due amount by a bank draft 17,400, and the total amount will be 34,000. Like this, we have to prepare consignor account in the books of consignee. Okay, students, I hope you understood how to make working notes from the given problem, and what are the ledger accounts we need to prepare in the books of consignor, and what are the ledger accounts we need to prepare in the books of consignee. So these three steps are important in this problem. Okay, students, so let me tell you the same points once again. Before going to do any problem, we need to read the problem and try to understand all the points that are given in the problem, and at last you observe what we are asked to do in that problem. So here, then we can go to make working notes. We can go to make working notes from the given problem. After that, you can go to prepare ledger accounts in the books of consignor. After that, you can go to prepare ledger accounts in the books of consignee. And this is the way how to prepare the ledger accounts in the books of consignor as well as consignee. Okay, students, I hope you understood all the points. Thank you for watching this video.